Give it up for Daughter Maitland.
Her name is Margot. Now, Margot listen, Bingham.
No, not today. Not today.
But even the way you introduced her wouldn't be a way people would know her. Like, you're the only one who remembers her name. We just know that she's the pretty girl on Boardwalk Empire. Like
a, no, she's the hottest girl that would ever been on Boardwalk. She was topless on Boardwalk. Wow. She had sex on Boardwalk.
Thank you for bringing that up.
Sorry.
It's important to my character.
Yo, you ruined the compliment before you'd finished it.
What? Yes.
You're the worst, the worst ever.
Talking to the mic. Margot Bingham said, give it up
for her.
She's back.
Oh, back. So now you're right after. Damn, how do we handle this?
We're going to have to. No, there's a spoiler alert. If you haven't watched this episode, wait and watch this video after you watch the final episode.
All right, so turn it off. But for those of us, or not me, because I haven't seen it, but those of you that have, your character's over. It's done.
She is over. But technically, you don't know that. Right. You just, you know.
That's
we can't even
Well, because the last time you left the show, you kind of like disappeared.
I disappeared, and then I disappear again.
Yeah,
so
but
she just does a disappearing act.
I'm a little confused. Do you have a complete understanding of everything about your character in the final episode?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So she was saying that where was she the entire time? She's been working for a dude.
Right.
Cleaning toilets. She's been cleaning toilets. Right. Which sucks.
Housemaid.
And then why did she come back to Dr. Narcisse at the time at which we found her?
She came back because she wanted a life for her daughter, which now daughter has a daughter. And she wasn't being able to be played anywhere. And she knew that the money that she was going to be able to make was in music. And he blacklisted her name. Like, pretty much.
Yeah, remember she had the vinyl that she saved
she
up
was like,
and she pressed it on her
and she
own?
Says, and she's like, I paid for this on my own money, you know, like with my own money. I paid for my musicians. I paid for the studio time.
And
but
no
nobody
play
will play it because of Dr. Narcisse. He blacklisted her.
Mm-hmm. And why? And he would have blacklisted her because she ran away?
Because she ran away and he wanted her to come back.
And he was trying
and
to get
she
her.
She did.
And she eventually did
she
come
did,
back.
Because she needed him.
And then Chalky convinced they come up with a deal in which he's going to free her supposedly.
Right.
But you don't
which
know.
Which you would like to think that everybody is free, but then, you know, Chalky ends with the line that he's like, you know, none of us are really free in the end.
So let me ask you a question.
Oh my God, I can't.
Are you
did you
sad?
Really cry
it's
for
still
real?
Fresh. It's still fresh. I was really crying. No,
last
okay,
night, you were crying.
Okay, I have to say a little personal story. So when I got this script, and I read that Michael died. I lost.
Michael didn't die. It was Chalky.
That Chalky
Michael's
died.
Fine. He's alive and well.
And for everybody that doesn't know this, like everybody dies this season, so like you knew it was either going to be this episode or next episode. Like, come on.
Like cats are dying.
Right. Like people die. So, but when I found out that he died, I literally lost it. I was like reading it in my living room, and I lost it in my life. Ugh. And I called him and I think I might have been going through something, I don't know what I was doing, but and he actually answered and he was like, what's up, baby girl, what's going on? And I was like, my heart is broken.
Did he say it?
And I said it like that and he's like, what's wrong? And I was like, my other half. And he was like, you need to chill out. And I was like, okay.
Did he say it like
writing
baby girl regular? Or did he say it like baby girl? Like he does on the
why,
show.
Why you got
it? That's how he taught. Was it like, no?
That was actually really good. Can we do that one more time?
No, I can't. But the point is, you use the same words that he actually uses on the show, but I'm guessing he didn't say it that way.
No, it was more like a Michael, like, yo, baby girl.
Okay, I'm casual.
It was a cash baby
girl. Are you sadder?
Baby girl.
Are you sad? I didn't say it like that, by the way. Are you sadder? So you were sadder about Chalky biting it than you were about you leaving. Your character leaving.
Yeah. I mean, me as Margot was sad to see Chalky bite it, but like me as daughter, I think her focus is on her daughter, obviously.
So it's a positive, you know, for her character, essentially.
Yeah,
she has a chance to live.
She has a chance, you know, like now she's moving forward and she might live, you know, she might be able to.
Okay, wait. Let's go back to daughter's character for
yes.
a second. Daughter was originally a young girl that Dr. Narcisse raised,
right.
correct?
Right.
Who was the daughter of a prostitute,
right?
Correct?
Mm-hmm. Who he killed. And she saw it all happen.
Right.
Right.
Was daughter ever a prostitute, or was she did she grow up under Dr. Narcisse and then become Dr. Narcisse's lover?
She was a prostitute within a sense because she was like his own puppet. You know, she was a prostitute as far as like selling herself for performance.
Right.
But it wasn't a sexual performance. It was.
But she was having sex with him.
I don't think that she was having sex with him. I think that, that they had like a sick, narcissistic kind of relationship. No pun intended, but little relationship between the two of them. But I think that if anything, it was more of like a weird kind of connection that like the weird ritualistic, like the religion ritualistic things that they used to do, like her wiping his chest and wiping his burns and washing him, you know, like the washing and the touching, like that was enough.
Because it kind of like watching it was almost like Daughter Maitland never having a man around because her mom was a prostitute. She only saw men come in and out.
Right.
And she she didn't really have the ability to understand a male relationship.
And she also
than through sex.
Right. And the only the only real love that she's ever known is from somebody that killed her own blood. So like that alone is like a headache to think about. But like I think that their relationship was so twisted that it was almost like enough for her to just kind of be his. Like she knew that he knew that she was always his and she could never go anywhere. Like,
so do we ever get confirmation on whose daughter has?
Yes.
Yeah, it gets
Confirmed because I haven't seen this episode yet.
It gets confirmed.
Mm-hmm.
Just tell me.
My daughter says something.
It's Chalky.
Along the lines that it might be.
Because you and Chalky was doing
not
it.
Not Narcissus, yeah.
Ebro, they weren't having sex in real life. It was just.
It looked like it. Let's be honest.
It did?
It looked. You didn't
did
see
it?
I don't remember this.
Because, like, kudos to me. Like,
No. She was on top.
I'll take that.
Chalky was on the bottom. They was grinding. It was doing it.
I forgot about that.
Yeah.
You really hold on to those moments, huh?
I mean, she's high. Why wouldn't I?
I know, but it's just like it's just a TV show.
I saw my friend Margot naked.
That's pretty exciting.
That's kind of weird.
That's as far as it's ever going to get.
That's a little weird.
Yeah, you just love to make things weird. Now, so.
I felt comfortable coming in, and now I don't.
And now it's ruined.
Now it's back.
You look good, though.
Thank you. No appreciate problem. It. Keep it together. Thank you very much.
Keep it together. So, two episodes left. I'm having a moment. I think I'm actually going to write an article about this that I'm pretty excited about. Yes?
Really?
About Boardwalk. Because we're watching Boardwalk End, and I gotta tell you the truth, and I actually ran into Steve Buscemi and told him the same thing.
Yeah.
I'm constantly amazed by the amount of people that say they don't watch Boardwalk Empire. And I think that's one of the reasons the show is coming to an end, frankly.
Right,
he said, basically, it's too expensive and there's not enough viewers.
Right.
And you guys don't get the press that a lot of the other big shows get. And I just think it's such a fucking bummer because the show is, like, nearly flawless. It's such an amazing show.
I mean, it's, like, cinematography-wise, it's been, like, incredible. It's been a dream and incredible. And the costumes and, like, the way that it's shot. We're one of the only TV series that are still shot on, like, a 35 film. Like, nobody shoots on film anymore, you know. Mm-hmm. And actually, like, just a little insider, this season they tried to shoot digitally and then it just didn't come out the way that they thought it was gonna look,
and you had to redo it,
and then they started going back to film, like, wow. You know, like, come
that's
on
expensive.
Like, it's kind of like, you know, fifth season, you know what works, but I think that they wanted to try to see if it could work digitally, and
but does
it's
got to,
like,
feel
it
old.
But does it feel vintage?
But my question is, does it annoy you when, like, for example, I love Walking Dead. I think it's a really enjoyable, entertaining show. But it's apples and oranges in terms of, like, the level sort of television you're watching. And then over the last few years, I've noticed that tons of people who never used to watch Walking Dead because of the promotion and the popularity of it are now all Walking Dead watchers.
Yeah.
That hasn't happened with Boardwalk.
No, it hasn't.
You guys didn't create new viewers. Is that does it annoy you at all?
It doesn't. I mean, it's annoying because it's like nobody really knows the unbelievable material that this is. It's like, you know, it's like a gem, I guess. It's exciting for people to kind of stumble upon it. But, I mean, I don't know. It's an experience. It's like, you know, either you like it or you don't.
I honestly think in a weird way, it ending this way and the fact that it does have its own following, later on it'll be appreciated more because it never became what people who know what great quality content is know what this is. Does that make sense? Like later on, it'll be one of those, it's kind of like The Wire when people go back and there
it
are people.
It is legendary.
Like, in the last few years, there's been like this whole movement of people like, hey, did you see The Wire? Have you watched The Wire? And it was amazing. It was well done for several reasons, I think, and hope that this will be like that. The music last season, that was last season when you were singing and all of that. Talk about that, because I had a chance to ask you about it. That is you singing and music that you guys put together specifically for this show that sounded like it was done in the 20s.
Yes. There is a band that is called Vince Giordano and the Nighthawks, and they perform, they've been a band for like 10 years. Mm. They perform every Monday and Tuesday at the Iguana in Midtown, and they have been the Boardwalk band since Boardwalk began, and they do all of the 1920s. They only are like a 1920s band.
And that's you actually singing.
That is me actually singing.
She's an actual singer.
I'm an actual singer.
Margot
Bingham.
We
know this. To a not actual.
No, but we know this. But singer. I think for the people watching right now, they may see it. Yes. You know, you see people sing on things all the time, but you don't know that that's
a
crap.
A lot of people think I lip sync a lot, but I actually look ridiculous lip syncing. So anytime, believe it or not. So every time that I shot like any kind of episode for the season, I had to sing it. Like I had to sing it over and over again. So there were times that we did like a huge extra scene with like 200 extras, and I would just like perform it like 100 times. Cause I look really stupid.
Even lip syncing your own stuff.
Yeah. I feel like an idiot.
It's hard to believe
like,
she looks stupid. It's hard to believe.
What's going on with your music career this very moment?
Working on new stuff as we speak.
New album or something?
Just new music. New music, yeah, new stuff. Hopefully going to be putting out an album, but for right now, my main goal is just to get some good stuff that I'm really, really proud of and really excited about and really polished and put it out.
Does your music sound anything like the stuff you do on board? Like, is it vintage like that? Like, what does it sound like?
I mean, it sounds like my voice. My voice is, like, gritty on its own, but it as far as, like, the era, it's more of a modern day funky soul.
Got it. Yeah, because I was wondering, like, if your fans expected that from you. Like,
they do. It's kind of, right? You know, they come to my shows.
Your character perform.
And they, people hire me for gigs and they're always like, you know, please do your own stuff and, you know, come as yourself. And then you get there and they're like, if you can, just throw in, like, you know, some of the show, you know, like maybe the way you look and stand and the way you talk. I'm like, so basically you just want Daughter, but you know, you just don't want to go through HBO for it. But you know, that's basically what it is. But like, I've had people at my shows, I play at Rockwood all the time downtown. And there was this guy that like, there was like this group of like five guys that just got wasted. And they were like, I'm the real Chalky White. I'm the real Omar. And I was like, wrong show. It's not even the right show. And plus like, this is real life. Like talking about real life fantasy. Fictional, real life
people want fantasy. Even when you tell them something is fiction, they want to believe that fiction is real for their own weird, I don't know, enjoyment and entertainment. So what happens for you now? Now your Boardwalk's done. Are you working on other shows? Are you like an HBO? Are you going to do another HBO thing? Are you doing movies? Like what? Do you just do music now? Like what happens for you?
No, I'm trying to do it all. I just wrapped a TV show in LA. Robert Rodriguez's new network, who was the director of Sin City, he just started a network called the El Rey Network, mostly a Latino network. Right now, Dawn of the Dead with Quentin Tarantino's Dawn of the Dead is on there, but we are the first original TV show called Matador. So I play like a computer nerd. Like glorified CIA logistics analyst, which is super fun because it's modern and it's kind of like, you know, that CSI kind of like undercover.
And totally different from what you were doing.
Totally different. And I'm a total nerd and I have like, I'm the character with the text. I'm that character, you know, like that one character that just has so much to say. Mm. And you're like, I don't understand. What is she talking about? That's me. And then I just got picked up for a movie that starts in November 1st in Detroit. So...
Very busy for you.
Very busy.
Well, we're here, man. When the music gets right and when all these big other endeavors start to pop off, come by so we can make sure the audience is in tune with it.
Cool. When I get famous enough, you guys can actually help me out. Thank you.
What do you mean? No, we want to help. Like, I'm just trying to...
We want to help now. We're trying to help now.
Why are you giving me a hard time?
Thanks, boo-boo.
Yeah. I have another question about the show. Sorry, real quick, one more thing. Why did the guy let Nucky's brother live?
What?
Remember, Remember?
Oh, yes, 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 yes.
Thank you.
Because he was supposed to finish him, and he was supposed to deliver the briefcase to someone else, remember?
When Nelson bites
him. He's like, here, buy yourself a train ticket.
And he's like, what am I supposed to do? And he flicks him a dollar as he buys himself a train ticket and walks out.
Right, because he didn't need to kill him.
Why? But why? Because he's going
to
leave now?
He needed to kill Nelson because he was choking Capone. And Capone and Ralph Capone was standing right behind him. So, like, if you wouldn't have done something, it would have been, like, suspicious. It would have been, like, why didn't you help? That's your boss. Why didn't you help? So he had to shoot him. So, but like the other dude, like he wasn't.
But is he now leaving Al Capone? He's not going to even be there anymore?
No, I don't get any of the scripts. So I don't know.
It's a little confusing though, right?
It's confusing, but like my assumption is like, dude has the ledgers now.
That's what I thought. He has the ledgers.
Yeah. You know, now he can.
Let's ask another question.
Now
what are ledgers?
Frame him, now he can frame.
Bank statements,
it's
man.
The bank statements.
The money.
Bank statements. Yes. Okay, that's what I thought. I'm making sure. So
it's like when you write out checks and you write out like and you keep like a statement.
Right,
like,
which is what the government wanted statement. To find yes. out that he was doing.
And,
crooked.
To do and the tax evasion
can,
stuff.
That's how they can frame him in tax fraud. But and that's like how eventually Capone went down. But I mean, he can honestly go back to the FBI and just like turn him in now and like have nothing to do with him, or he can go back and start. I mean, like I don't know. There's a lot of options.
It was a crazy. Options. It was a crazy episode. I mean, it was up there.
I'm watching it tonight. I know, I'm a father now. Just, all right, I have to put the baby down by 8:30. I was tired.
There was a kid on the show
exactly.
in with me.
Thank
she
you.
Was she was sitting next Very to cute. A gun. You could have just played it with your baby.
Exactly. It was baby material.
It's too much stimulation There's for a 2-month-old. I need darkness. I need quiet and lying babies to go to sleep.
Yo, at the end when
she
Chucky's
lays
about
down
to get
at
murked,
a time. We have order
the powerful
in my house.
Scene when her song is playing in his head when he closes his eyes. No. Oh,
and I, it was
that was a heartbreaker.
It was sweet at the rap party. They had like all 4 seasons, and they had like a recap of all 5 seasons, and they put it to "Dream a Little Dream." They put it to that song, and I was like, "Oh my God, you guys!"
You know, you really did. You came up in the sense that your part wasn't massive in the history of the show, but it was really memorable and utilized quite a bit. And obviously, they liked you enough. Like, they didn't have to close up your character.
They didn't have to bring me back. This
they didn't.
Year. No, yeah. Absolutely not. I mean, like, I didn't exist when I first got cast. I didn't even exist after I got cast. You know, like, I was supposed to be a background jazz singer.
Yeah, but you were hot.
You were trending.
There's a lot of
Twitter.
Hot girls on there.
Nah,
there's a lot of
not
hot girls.
Hot black girls.
Mm-mm.
No, you killed.
Nope.
You killed.
Sorry.
You're even, she's even on like all the season 4 promo, right? You're like even on all like, yeah. the outdoor campaigns yeah. and stuff, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, they flipped it. That's
just,
pretty
I
awesome.
I mean, I it's really,
just
I love
it.
I'm taking it.
Just take
own
it.
You were part of it.
I'm taking it.
Talk about
it.
Just stunt on people. You should just stunt all the time.
That's not me.
Yo, you guys,
keep
give
it classic.
Up.
Keep
give it
classic.
Up for friend of the show. Margot Bingham is her name. We know her as Daughter Maitland, but you should know about her music and her other endeavors as she branches out from this amazing character that she played on Boardwalk Empire into other things. And she's originally from Pittsburgh,
yes.
but she lives in Harlem. And congratulations on all your success.
Thank you, Ebro.
You guys,
Thank
give you it guys. Up for Margot Bingham.
By the way, if you know someone that well, you shouldn't say so many awkward things to them during an interview. Just
right?
saying. You disgust me.